Let's talk money. How about this and the effect on the market? Market watcher Rebecca Walser joins us now. Now, look, what do you make of this? I mean, we got futures pointing down about 80 points. We were down 470 yesterday. The market does not like this impasse, does it?
No, Stu, it doesn't. And I say these are the labor pains, and this is what it takes to make the sausage. It's ugly. It's going to be painful. And it's a pain that I will tell you I think we should welcome, because I'm not one to throw Wall Street on the bus here, but I will tell you that Wall Street has had, you know, a lot of, look at the Dow 30 and all the embed and, you know, top companies that benefit from China, you know, imports that have had these issues. So they don't want this deal necessarily, but long term, if you look at China's 2025 made in China, it is not a strategic relationship that we can sustain in America with China. So the market is not going to like this, but we have to deal with it.
I understand that. There's a dichotomy here between dealing with it economically and the market dealing with it. Is it your position that if there is no trade deal, and it looks unlikely at the moment, I have to say that, this market goes down from here?
Oh, there's no doubt, Stu. There is absolutely no doubt.
How much?
I think it is going to be, you know, what we saw yesterday, what we saw Monday that came back, you know, is going to look like a cakewalk. I think that, you know, we have strategically started to realize that we can't sustain long-term longevity with this China trade situation we have. And we have had such great news on it all year. This has been unexpected and a surprise. And I take Sue's point, but I think that why aren't these people reading these agreements that the negotiators have been putting forward and agreeing to all along? Why are they just now getting this 150-page document and striking and redlining it? I mean, it's ridiculous. So it's going to be painful, but we have to get it done. And China, you're right, China's going to have to try to save face, but we're not going to go with a deal. President Trump is not going to go with a deal that does not actually have teeth and actually make our trade balance change with China.
Okay, where we are now is a trade deal looks unlikely in the immediate future, and the market is down again. Rebecca, thank you very much. Oh, actually, stay there for a second. I've got another question coming up. Hold on. Let me deal with the Uber and Lyft. Both those two companies, their drivers are on strike in several cities this morning. They're going to strike for 2 hours during the rush hour. They are protesting pay, working conditions. My question is, does this action, does it threaten the basic business model of Uber and Lyft ride-sharing companies?
Not right now, because the drivers are considered independent contractors, not employees, so they don't get health benefits, and they make an hourly wage. But the problem is that they feel that they should be paid more. They should be sharing in the wealth of these companies, especially if you're having an IPO that's valuing the company at $91 billion on Friday. But, you know, Uber has said that, look, over the years, we have 1.1 million drivers in the U.S. They've been paid a lot of money. Sorry, look, globally, they've been paid a lot of money, $78 billion, actually, for 3.8 million drivers around the world.
The drivers want more money, and they want unionization.
Yeah.
If they get more money, doesn't that crimp the bottom line of Lyft and Uber, restrict their profitability?
But
and if they get unionization, doesn't that threaten their business model?
They work on a freelance basis.
I know they do, but if they get unionization, does that destroy their business model?
Well, they've been fighting this for many years. I don't think the government has been siding with them in terms of getting unionization and full employee
I don't
benefits.
Care, but if they get unionization, does that affect the business model of Uber and Lyft?
The most important part is if. That's a big question at this point.
Okay, answer the question. If they are unionized,
then they would have
then
they would crimp the margins, and yes, revenue and profit would go down.
And does it affect the business model, which is
probably
the release of everyone's personal assets here?
Yeah,
right?
Probably. But but they're also getting cash bonuses to 1.1 million drivers, so they can participate in the IPO on Friday as well.
Okay, Rebecca, come back in again, please. Would you buy Uber on the day it goes public or within the first 6 months? Would you buy them?
Well, it depends on your long-term strategy. I think long-term, there are some business model threats here, major. They've already, a tribunal in the UK, Stu, has already decided wrongly, I think, that these are employees, and this is being appealed to the UK Supreme Court. So Uber has made a filing regarding that and disclosure regarding that. Lyft has also made a disclosure on their filings regarding the fact that the business model could go from IC, independent contractor, to full-time employee, which would impact their bottom line and their earnings greatly. This has been, you know, an amazing app and an amazing company because of the fact that they have this business model. And this is, you are returning to a business model of old. Employees, benefits, you know, worker protections, all of these things would absolutely have a huge impact. So as far as the IPO on Friday, this is not the best time to have a strike this morning. Not great timing, but the drivers did that intentionally. So
yeah, it's absolutely deliberate. Rebecca, thank you very much indeed. Great to have you on the show on a very busy morning. Okay. Yeah, I'm really going to change.